A new function is coming to Excel, the translate function. With this function, you can do something like this. You can set up a data entry form. So for example, here we have a business planning form, and we want to make sure everyone on the team understands what each activity is. I'm going to add a drop down here for language. Now, currently we have it in English, but I can switch it to German, and they're going to see the list of activities in the German language, then Spanish and French. Now, you aren't restricted to four languages. In fact, you can choose from over 100 languages. Another cool use case is if you are preparing a set of instructions for your report and you want to make sure everyone on the team understands what to do. You can add the language here on top. This is the instructions in English, and then we can switch this to German, for example. Pretty cool, right? Now, before I show you how you can set these up from scratch, let me introduce you to Excel's new translate function. Here I have some text in German that I want translated into English, and I want to do it in a dynamic way. So I'm going to go over here, type in an equals, and start typing in translate, and I see it on this list, so I'm going to press tab. The first thing I need is the text that I want translated, which is sitting in this cell. Then I get to define the source language. So in which language is this text that I just selected? Well, this is German, so I can scroll down to find the code, which is right here. So I'm going to click this, and I get DE in quotations. You can also type these in manually if you know what they are. I want to translate this, let's say, into English. So in quotations, I'm just going to type in EN, close the bracket, press enter, and my text is translated into English. If I wanted to translate it into Spanish, I'm going to change this to ES, and that's it in Spanish. So you have lots of choices here. Let's say I want to translate this into Greek. I'm going to select that, press enter, and that's that in Greek. I have no idea if this is correct or not, so if you can speak Greek, let me know in the comments if this is a correct translation. Now, here's another cool thing about this function. If I just remove this and I go back here and type in translate, select a text, close the bracket, and enter, I get my text translated into English. How does it know to translate this into English? Is English the default? No, it's not. It uses my system settings. So if I don't specify the target language, it picks it up based on my system settings. And if you also don't specify the source language, it tries to detect it automatically. If we have the sentence in English that we want to translate into German, I'm going to select this text. I can define the source language to be English, or I can skip it if I wanted to detect it. And then I'm going to put the language code, press enter, and I have it in German. Now, another related function was also released. That function is the detect language function. So if I come over here and type in detect language, all I need to provide it is the text, and it returns the language code. So if I press enter now, I get EN here, and let's bring this up, we get DE. Now that we know how to use the translate function, let's apply it to some practical use cases. So here I have a list of instructions that I want translated into different languages depending on whatever the user selects from this dropdown. I don't have a dropdown yet, so let's go ahead and insert one. I'll go to data, data validation, let's go with list, and I'll just type in the language codes. So EN for English, DE for German, ES Spanish, and FR for French, and then press enter. Okay, so my dropdown is there. Now I need to connect this with the value that the user selects from this dropdown. This means that we need to replace these with formulas. So what I'm going to do is Control C this and paste it somewhere to the side here. I'll go here and Control V. Now we're going to change these to the translate function. The text that I want is right here. The source language is EN, The destination language is whatever the user selects from this dropdown. And I'm going to fix it using the F4 key, close the bracket, press enter. And now let's just switch this to German that we can see it works. Yeah, it works. Now, if you want to be on the safe side, you can also use the if error function so that in case your result is an error, you just default to whatever is written here. Close the bracket, press enter. Now, let's just copy these down. I'm going to highlight this range, press F2, control enter, and we get everything translated into German and Spanish if we select Spanish from the dropdown. Now, once you have this set up, you can go ahead and hide all of these, or you can group the columns that have your original information. Now, what if you didn't want to show the language code in your dropdown, but instead you wanted to show the full text, so German instead of DE? All you have to do is add one more step to your formula. So first of all, let's do our dropdown here. I'll go to data, data validation, list. This time I have my values right here in Excel, so I'm going to reference them and click on OK. Now the person can choose between German, English, Spanish, and French. Because I want to connect these ultimately to this value in the dropdown, I have to move these out of the way and write formulas here. So I'm going to copy this whole bit, go to the side somewhere, and Control V this. So now instead of the text, we're going to use the translate function. The text we want translated starts from here. The language of this text is English, so I'm going to put EN in quotations. I want to translate it into this language, but if I just select this, close the bracket and press enter, I get an error. I need to provide the language code to the formula. So what I can do is use VLOOKUP or XLOOKUP to get the code. And I have them right here. So let's go back to our formula, update this to XLOOKUP. My lookup value is right here. I'm going to fix it using F4. The lookup array is here. Let's fix with F4. What I want returned is right beside it. Let's fix with F4 and close the bracket, press enter, and now we get our text in German. Now again, you can put this inside the if error function if you want to be on the safe side. Otherwise, we can just copy this whole thing down. Let's just select this range, F2, control enter. Okay, now this as well, I'm just going to drag this to the side. Okay, so now we can easily switch between the different languages. I find this to be a pretty cool function. I remember in my old job, we had to translate some instructions into different languages, and we got them translated and we, you know, copied and pasted them in another table, and then we used VLOOKUPs to look up these different languages. But the problem was that every time we added a new sentence or we added new instructions, we had to maintain the other languages as well. So I think it's pretty cool to have everything dynamic, especially for cases like this. Let me know what you think in the comments. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you in the next one.